Hey guys, so today I'm here to show you a sequence from yoga, alignment yoga, that you can do at home anytime to help low back pain. So why? Because chances are you guys out there have either had a low back issue or you don't want one. So it's good for both of those. All right, we've got Titus helping me out today, and so let's get started. So Titus, come to what's called child's pose. So you bring your toes together, and then your knees right to the outside edges of the mat. Good. Now extend your arms forward and let your hips relax back onto your heels. Let your head, your forehead come to the ground. Now guys, if this is a little bit intense, you can always bring your knees closer together and then come down to child's pose from there. Good. So take some nice deep breaths. It's really important to breathe through this whole thing, because if you're not breathing, your body thinks that it's in fight or flight mode, and that's going to cause everything to tense up. So keep breathing. It's not just a yoga thing. Good. Come back up to the beginning position. Walk your knees a little bit wider, and then sit right back into the position you were just in. So bring your hips down. Good. This stretches through your inner thighs, which can be a major source of low back issues if they're tight. Again, super important to keep that breath moving. Good, now come back up. Good, come to all fours. So bring your shoulders directly over your wrists and bring your knees directly underneath your hips. Awesome. With a nice deep breath in, look up, push your mid back down. This is called cow pose. Move your hips side to side. Nice. Feels really good. And now push your ribs up, take a deep breath out. Push your low back area up to the ceiling, and then move your hips side to side again. Good. Do that one more time, both positions. So take a deep breath in. Especially push your mid back down. That's where I see a lot of really weird stuff going on. So make sure you're pushing your mid back down. And then push your ribs up. Again, you can move your hips side to side, stretching through your sacrum and your low back. Lots of different lines of fascia. Good, come back to the start. Nice. How are you feeling? So walk your hands all the way over to the right. Drop onto your right forearm and push your fingers forward, grip it to the ground with your left palm. Now push through your left hip. You should feel a really nice stretch all the way through your left side. Lat, hip, wherever you're tight is where you're going to feel this. Again, keep that breath moving. Nice deep breath in, especially through your nose. Come back to the beginning. And switch sides. So now walk your hands all the way over to the left. Drop down onto your left forearm. Extend your right hand forward and push your right palm down into the ground or mat. Push your right hip back and stretch through your whole right side. The more you breathe, the deeper you breathe, the slower you breathe, the more relaxed you'll become. Good. Come back up. Excellent. All right. Come up into a push-up position. Push-up preparation. and bring your feet a little bit wider than the hip width distance. Without moving your hands or feet, lift your hips up, and then this is the famous downward facing dog. Bend your knees and lift your hips a little bit higher. Let your heels drop to the ground. Good. This position decompresses your spine. So you can do this between like sets of squats or sets of deadlifts to just give your spine a little bit of a break. Walk your hands back toward your feet. Point your toes forward and bring your feet parallel and hip width distance or a little wider. Bend your knees if you need to, that's fine. You don't have to be a superhero. We don't want to piss off any hamstrings. Good. Interlace your fingers into the crooks of your elbows. Let your torso really, really just hang on your thighs. Nice. Let your neck be totally loose. Rotate your knees out slightly. And now gently sway side to side. Again, make sure you're breathing. Good. Let your hands come down to the mat. And now come down to your seat. Good. All right, next, walk your, or extend your legs forward. And roll all the way onto your back. Nice. Lift your knees up so they're at a 90 degree angle. And now windmill your legs so that your right knee comes over your left. Reach down and grab either your shins or your ankles if you're flexible. Good. This is called whale tail. This is going to stretch all through your hips, which is a major contributor to low back issues. You can also gently rock side to side. Again, just feel around for the tighter areas. And the more you pull your legs in toward you, the deeper the stretch will be. Slowly release that. And then unwind your legs and rewind them so that your left knee comes on top of your right. Reach down and grab your shins or your ankles and pull your legs in toward you. Again, option to move side to side. Good. Release that. And then for the last bit, bring your feet to the mat, knees up. Drop your knees over to the right and bring your right hand on top of your left knee. Open up and look at your left hand. Take a deep breath in. And a deep breath out. Come back to the beginning position. So your knees will point straight up. Drop your knees to the left. Bring your left hand on top of your right knee. And open up. Look at your right hand. Deep breath in. Deep breath out. Come back to the start. Keep your feet together and let your knees drop out to the sides. Nice. Now this, you can hang out here for as long as you like. It's just a passive adductor stretch, again, stretching out some of the muscles that can contribute to that low back tightness that you might be feeling. Whenever you are finished, bring your hands underneath your knees. Pull your knees together and then come back up to seated. So this is just a quick little series of yoga stretches from alignment yoga that you can do anytime to help your low back and just mobility in general. So enjoy, thanks.